I climbed Mount Everest, the highest point of our planet, twice, and quite successfully so, which is why I am alive and I'm here. But let me tell you, hundreds of climbers make it to the top of Mount Everest every year. So what's different about my climb? Well, no one had done it as a vegan before I did it. Sounds extraordinary? Let me tell you why it's no different than climbing Everest as a non-vegan. But why climb Mount Everest at all? This question is something that I'm asked every single time. Well, I will take you back to October of 2010. I had signed up for a hike to walk to Mount Everest base camp. I wanted to see the tallest mountain of the world up close. So I landed in Kathmandu and I took a flight to Lukla, which is also one of the most dangerous airports in the world. After I survived the flight, we had to walk for about 10 days and it was some of the most spectacular scenery that I had seen in my entire life. And then we reached the base camp of a mountain called Pumori, which is also known as the daughter of Everest. We were stationed in the dining tent that evening, and basically it was like an absolute luxury at 18,000 feet. And then someone was like sort of shouting my name outside. And in the mountains, it's usually never good. So I quickly ran out and I witnessed the most magical moment of my entire life. The last rays of sunset were falling directly on Everest. Every other mountain had faded away into the colors of gray and blue. Everest was burning golden in color. And when I saw Everest this way, I fell in love and I found my dream. I promised myself that I'll come back one day and as much impossible it seems, I will reach the top of Mount Everest. Another question that I constantly get asked is, why vegan at all? Growing up in a vegetarian family, I always believed that animals are sentient and emotional beings with individual characters, and that they have equal right to live freely and happily as much as we do. In 2001, I moved to the United States to pursue my master's degree. It is there where my roommate started exposing me to the horrors of the dairy and the leather industry. After that conversation, I connected the dots that the piece of steak, the glass of milk, a block of cheese, or the leather belt that I was wearing are all the same and come from abused animals. I was not able to reconcile with the fact that as a vegetarian, I was continuing to contribute to animal cruelty and abuse. I had to take a stand, and that is the moment when I turned vegan. Now, when I came back home from October 2010 from the Everest base camp trip, I promised myself that I was going to climb Mount Everest as a vegan or not do it at all. And then I remembered a very sort of a distinct saying from my expedition leader. He told me, "Kuntal, to climb to the top of the world, you need a top of the world body and you need a top of the world mind." For the next 4 years, I worked really hard to prepare that top of the world body and mind. And finally, I was ready to climb Mount Everest in 2014. And after a few days into the climb, we got the news that 17 Sherpa guides died in an ice avalanche in the Khumbu icefall area near the base camp. This was the single largest accident in the climbing history of Mount Everest. The mountain was deemed unsafe and all expeditions to Everest were cancelled that year. We turned around and came home. I decided to go back to climb Mount Everest in 2015. This time around, a 7.9 magnitude earthquake, the largest to hit Nepal in a century, happened. It resulted in a massive avalanche that hit the Everest base camp. I remember that moment when we were faced by this giant cloud of snow and ice from left to the sky, to the right to the sky. It was just about to hit us. In that moment, I didn't think that I was going to die. I was very certain that I was going to die. I narrowly escaped death, but 19 other climbers weren't so lucky. This was no longer a mountain climbing tragedy, a tragedy of unprecedented levels. 10,000 people had died in Nepal. All the expeditions in Everest, including all other mountains, were cancelled, and we turned around and we came home. I had tried climbing Everest twice and I had failed twice. I was now starting to have my own self-doubts. But climbing Everest was the biggest dream of my life. And for the last 6 years, I had spent every waking moment chasing that dream. If I gave up, then regrets for the rest of the life were only going to be mine. So I decided to go back one last time and give it everything I had to reach the top. Finally, in 2016, I tasted success. I remember the morning of May 19th, 2016. I was super tired, miserable, cold, but at the same time ecstatic. Tears were rolling down my cheeks and they had already frozen. The temperature was minus 40 degrees Celsius, and I was standing on the very top of the Mount Everest, very top of the world. And I had achieved the biggest dream of my life, climbing Mount Everest as a 100% vegan. Or did I? Now, this suit that you are seeing that I was wearing on the top of Mount Everest, this suit is built from the feathers of a slaughtered geese. It's called down. This suit is built in such a way that it protects us in temperatures of minus 50 degrees Celsius. Before my first attempt, I had reached out to many of the major gear manufacturers across the world, asking them to build an animal-free suit for me. They all rejected my idea and said, the alternative for down simply does not exist for 8,000 meter mountains climbing. I compromised and wore a dead animal on my body. But I did not give up. I continued searching for an animal-free suit. I wrote to a company called Save the Duck, which specialized in manufacturing animal-free jackets. And even though they did not have any mountaineering gear on their catalog, they agreed to build an animal-free suit for me. For both of us shared the same vision. After about 8 months of research and development, Save the Duck created one of the first animal-free suit for 8,000 meter mountains of the world. And guess what? 50% of the suit was created from recycled materials. That is the plastic bottles that are thrown away and the fishing nets that plague our oceans. Having this suit, I decided it was time to go back to Mount Everest again and complete my dream. But I was worried and scared. The suit had never been tested in extreme conditions before. I would be risking my life, my fingers, my toes, high up inside the death zone, in bone-chilling winds, cold, and thin air. But I was ready, more than ever, for the animals. In May 2016, I climbed to the top of Mount Lhotse, the fourth highest mountain, standing tall at 28,000 feet. And I was wearing that animal-free suit from Save the Duck. I reached the top and came back down without a scratch, no frostbite, no illnesses, no cough. And this was the time I said, now it's time to go back to Mount Everest. This time around, I chose to climb Mount Everest from the Chinese side, which is known to be colder and windier. I wanted to test my animal-free suit in some of the harshest conditions possible. I told myself, if I could stay warm and climb safe, then I could prove that this suit works. And yes, high-quality gear is of utmost importance to a climber's success on the big mountains, but it is disciplined and consistent training combined with many, many years of serious climbing experience that puts the climber on the top. In April this year, I found myself at Everest Base Camp yet again, hungry to fulfill my long pending dream. After about 45 days of climbing, we reached Camp 3. At 27,200 feet, this is the highest campsite on our planet. It is located in an area called the Death Zone. The air is so thin up here that you are literally living on borrowed time. At 9:30 that evening, Mingma Tenzi Sherpa, my climbing partner, and I started the final push to reach the top of Mount Everest. Now, this year had been relatively bad winds and bad weather, which meant that there was hardly any snow on the mountain. It was mostly a lot of rock and ice. As we climbed through the night, we passed bodies of four deceased climbers from past few years, well preserved, and a stark reminder that if I made any mistake, I was going to be right there forever and ever. So both Mingma and I stayed razor sharp focused, climbed through the night. Next morning at 5:30 in the morning, we were standing on the very top of Mount Everest. I had achieved the biggest dream of my life this time around, a 100% vegan ascent of Mount Everest, both from a diet and a gear perspective. And this time, I proudly flew the vegan flag on the top, knowing that no animal had to suffer or die for my dream to come true. Now, I'll tell you this one instance that happened on the night when I was climbing Everest. We had just reached the base of the treacherous second step. At 28,800 feet, it's a sheer vertical rock wall of 40 feet. Half dead, I looked up the wall and I questioned myself, why am I here? What am I doing? Let's just pack up and go home. And then I took a step back and recounted all those failed expeditions, the near-death experiences, my inability to find an animal-free suit, and so many people coming and telling me, Kuntal, it is impossible. You don't have what it takes to climb this mountain. And yet, I was here, merely 200 feet away from achieving the biggest dream of my life, one that I had worked really hard for. I told myself, I had to do this for myself and for the animals, and that I cannot give up now. I put one foot in front of another and did that a few thousand times, and just like that, I reached the top of Mount Everest. Standing here, I can tell you from experience that there will be obstacles in every journey we take in life. May it be creating your new startup, may it be climbing Mount Everest, or maybe paying your college tuition, or for matter, maybe building a six-pack abs. And I can assure you that each one of us in this room, including myself, is going to fail at some point during this journey. But each one of us in this room has the grit to overcome those obstacles, learn from our failures, and achieve the biggest dreams of our life. All we have to do is keep going, not give up, put one step in front of another, and we will all make it to the top. Thank you so much.